Good evening to you all, and welcome back to my channel. My name remains Chekube Madichie. Today, I want us to look at panel autoregressive distributed light model using eView. So you can quickly call it a panel ARDL model in eView. Okay. Already, panel ARDL is not too far fetched from what we already know as per ARDL, and the benefits of this procedure is to be able to see both the short run and the long run coefficients. Okay, be able to estimate both short run and long run coefficient of the panel model. So I believe that the requisite knowledge can be easily found in relevant materials. There are 1001 research papers you can come across that have utilized the panel ARDL. So in this very example, I'll be making use of what appears to be heterogeneous dynamic panel, which of course that is ARDL, panel ARDL, and the nature or the structure of this is that it is a heterogeneous panel. Heterogeneous in the sense that the time scope or time coverage or the year is far greater than the number of individuals, okay, or the group. So our major concern is to see the group mean, estimated group mean, or long run group mean of the model. And here in our work file, I have a ACEL, which translates to access to electricity. COCO, which means control of corruption, and FDI, which of course we know is foreign direct investment. So I'm going to experiment panel ARDL using these three variables, with FDI being the dependent variable. So we want to see how access to electricity and control of corruption influence foreign direct investments among these five countries. So the countries we have here, we have Nigeria, we have Ghana, we have Sierra Leone, we have Liberia, and we have Gambia. So these are the five countries that we have here. The time coverage, 1996 to 2018. These are the what we have. So how do we begin? There are certain things we can do, which are, most of them are optional. You can actually do descriptive statistic, can go into descriptive statistics. Of course here we are not interested in that. Of course you know it's optional if you want to describe the data characteristics and the rest of them. Another thing we can actually do, can actually test for correlation, you know, to be sure that the explanatory variables or regressors are not correlated to a higher degree, so that multicollinearity will not be a serious problem. So another thing we can also do is to test for stationarity, to ensure that this actually is very important, to ensure that none of the variables is order two. Okay, is order two. So because for this procedure, non-stationary variables and that are integrated at order one, that is I1 variables are modeled, or a mix of I1 and I0 are actually modeled within this ARDL, and order two is not actually accounted for. So in that case, will be testing for stationarity, and for co-integration, it is still optional because we can actually find out from the results whether there is co-integration or not. You can also test for co-integration using any panel co-integration method. If you want, it is still optional, but then because the result can actually show us whether there is co-integration. So let us begin with a stationarity test. This is a variable here. Okay, we test for stationarity. Stationarity. Okay, you can see cross-sectionally independent and cross-sectionally dependent. So we assume cross-sectionally independent, that the time series are cross-sectionally independent. Okay, here we have various procedures, but we can go for summary. Can go for summary and see all the result at a time. Okay, so we click OK. Now this is the Levi, that's LLC result, not significant. Every other one not significant. So this shows that we cannot reject the null hypothesis of unit root. We can test again at first difference and see what we can find out. And from here, you see that all the test statistics become significant. So we reject, so which means that this variable is other one variable. So we can also test the other variable for unit root and start with level. From there you see that we cannot reject the null. We test again at first difference. What can you see? You see that we reject the null at first difference. So this also is order one. So we go for FDI. What can we see? We start the test at level. You can see that some are significant, like this PP, Philipperon Fischer combined Fischer chi square. Is telling us that it's significant, but majority of the test statistics here are not significant, which simply means that we conclude that it is not significant. We test again at first difference. What can we find out? It becomes significant. Only LLC is insignificant, but others, so majority are rejecting the null. So we now found that all the variables are order one variable. So remember that the ARDL goes with all variables order one, can also go with all variables order zero, and it can also go with combination of order one and order zero. This simply means that we can actually model them. So with this, we proceed to the panel ARDL, go to make equation. We come here and change the estimation method to PMG, that is pull mean group, so ARDL. It gives us this environment. What do we do here? We set up the model. We can use fix by using our manual method to input the lags. Okay, now that is based on you having to test for going to lag selection. And of course, sometimes it becomes problem determining the lag selection. So what we normally do is to use automatic and put the maximum lag, okay, maximum number of lag, and set the information criterion. Most times we go for Akaike. So here I may decide to use 4 because it's already the default. We use constants, use 4 as the maximum lag, considering the time scope, which is not too large. With this, I can click OK. The result is showing us that the right model is 111. So the dependent variable is lag 1, and other variables are lag 1 in the ARDL model. And here we can see the long run equation and the short run equation. So from this result, we can see that the COCO, which is control of corrosion, is giving us positive sign. The control of corrosion is giving us positive sign. but only can only be said to be significant at 10%. And of course, if 5% is your choosing level of significant, it means that COCO is not statistically significant. Now, the second one, asset toxicity, is giving us negative sign. You can see negative sign here, and it is statistically significant because the p-value is less than 0.05. So this is for the long run. So what this means is that in the long run, this has positive sign but not statistically significant, but this has negative sign and statistically significant. Okay, now this is the short run equation. The first item here is the co-integrating equation, which is also conventionally regarded as the error correction time, and you can see that it is statistically significant with the right sign. The positive negative sign is the right sign, and this value is showing us that about 54.86% of the discrepancies between the actual and equilibrium FDI is corrected annually across the chosen countries. And of course, you can see COCO, which is a significant, and I mean not significant but positively influence FDI. You can see it in the short run, it is negative. So what this means is that in the short run, this variable has negative sign, but in the long run, it has positive sign. So what this also means is that any shock on this variable in the short run is expected to have a negative sign, but in the long run, it will turn and become positive. So now you can also see that there is also a change of sign in ACEEL from negative to positive, that in the short run it has positive sign, but in the long run it has negative sign. So but both short run and long run are not statistically significant at 5%. So these are the panel ARDL. You can see the long run equation, you can see the short run. Then there are other tests you can actually do. You can go for model selection summary. Here you can see how the model is chosen. This is where Akaike has the lowest value, and that gave us ARDL 111. Okay, so that's actually how this model was selected. So this model is better than this, better than, so the worst model here is this one here. So another thing you can also do is to look at cross-section. What I did here now is cross-section short run coefficient. This will tell you how the variables performs in the short run by country by country. You can see Nigeria, can see the speed of adjustment, can see that is significant to the tune of 80%. Can see other variables. Okay, with this you can compare this result with what we got in group, from the group estimation. So these are the variable countries. Okay, what other thing can you do? Now let us go back to the results. I talked about co-integration. How can we find that this model is co-integrated? It is from this error correction term. So the significance of this error correction term shows that the model is, that the variables are co-integrated. So from here you can see that it has negative sign, it is significant. So the negative sign shows that deviation, short run deviation, or short run shock deviation actually is restored or corrected in the long run. This simply means that when it is possible for variables to lose their equilibrium relationship in the short run, but in the long run, by virtue of this negative sign and significance of this parameter, long run equilibrium must be restored. So that is why with this parameter we can say that the variables are co-integrated. So this is actually the panel ARDL. I hope this video is useful. don't hesitate to ask question if you are confused. You can watch the video over and over again, because I know I'm a little bit faster. Okay, please, if today is your first time visiting my channel, kindly subscribe, and of course turn on the notification bell, so that anytime I post a video, you will see it first. Thank you very much, and God bless you.